Wait, this isn't Dark Souls.
Show me a moves.
Hello everyone and welcome. Today we find out if you can beat Dark Souls as Captain Falcon. Wait, what? Dark Souls doesn't really have anything that would even be remotely similar to Captain Falcon. How is this even possible? I mean, he's a futuristic race car driving bounty hunter and we're... naked. Well, there are two things that he's known for. Falcon Punch! contractually obligated to say it like that. And the Knee of Justice. There's nothing in this game that resembles a high damaging explosive punch, but there is a knee. Everyone knows about the kick animation designed to break through shields, but what I didn't even know until recently was that if you do the same move while empty-handed, you actually knee the enemy. Except it does literally nothing. Zero damage. So that's it then. Runs over. I guess I'll take my only keepsake, the Tiny Beings Ring, and just head back to my cell and how did that get there? Yeah, so with a little bit of modding magic, we turn the Tiny Beings Ring into the Orange Charred Ring. The primary use for this ring is to walk on lava, but it also gives the added effect of putting fire damage on our feet. For some reason. Doesn't matter because that means the knee now does damage. Now we're cooking with... Can you even say we're cooking with gas? This is more like cooking with a single piece of wet grass, but you know what? Whatever, it works. Just gotta start the match with a good old taunt. Wow, such disrespect. If there's one thing I learned in Smash, it's to never play neutral and always go for the knee. Hey, that's not too bad. Huh, these must be brawl hitboxes. Okay, so the damage looks serviceable. Bare fists and the sword hilt do less damage, so in theory, this shouldn't be that bad of a run. Right? Wrong. The asylum demon lured me into a false sense of, oh, this run won't be too bad, but I'm getting ahead of myself. So let's talk about why this is a horrible idea and you should never attempt it. The attack distance for the knee is incredibly short. I'm pretty sure it's less than the range of your bare fists. The damage can't be buffed in any substantial way. Additionally, a lot of bosses in this game are fairly tall and or have huge thigh gaps, meaning I'll flat out miss most of the time. It locks you in place, that is assuming you even use it instead of a punch, as it is sometimes tricky to input forward in R1, apparently. The only, and I mean only, upside is that it consumes very little stamina, but that is not at all worth the negatives. It's like getting into a fist fight, but your opponent is just an actual ICBM. You're gonna lose. At any rate, I push forward and down the asylum demon. Look at me. My naivety. I have no clue what is about to happen. This man trying to warn me. He's saying firebombs are better, do consumables only. In the undead burg, I quickly realize another weakness of this run. Groups of enemies. Since our attack range is so narrow, we can't hit multiple things at once to interrupt attacks. Instead, we just kinda get smacked around. Up the stairs, we expertly dodge the explosive barrel and onto the Taurus Demon. Well, that's not a knee. Neither was that. That's less than I was expecting, and I didn't expect a lot. Also, can we just talk about how bad these hitboxes are? Taurus Demon is the only boss in the game that I actually feel has awful hitboxes. I mean, don't get me wrong, there are several that are bad, but these are just... spicy. Well, that's one try down and we hardly put a dent in them. It wasn't until about 2 hours later where I realized this wasn't gonna be as easy as I thought, and I didn't think this was gonna be easy to begin with, but I am nothing if not determined. And eventually, we knee our way to victory. One down. Yay! Honestly though, this was rapidly becoming one of, or possibly the hardest thing I've ever tried to do in a Souls game. I knew something needed to change if I was ever gonna make it through this with my sanity intact. I began to ponder what else I could do. What would Douglas J. Falcon do? He'd play neutral and punch things. So we grab a couple cestus and get to work. Alright, fun behind the scenes fact, this was originally designed to be a knee only run, but it's actually just insanity to use only the knee. I tried. I was optimistic that with enough patience it could be done, but I severely underestimated the difficulty of this run. You'll still see me use it, but not as a primary damage source, more to just style on bosses. Maybe one day I'll return and do a true knee-only run, but today is just not that day.
What is this range?
Safety, 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 safety. Good. What? Oh no, I can't roll through him to get stage control! That attack is overpowered. Better nerf Greninja. So is this just gonna become a theme? We finally made our way to the Undead Merchant where we buy a whopping one charcoal pine resin. The Cessus have a strong attack that is a straight punch. If we light our hands on fire, it's like a poor man's falcon punch. This really is like Smash Bros. Look, it's Captain Falcon against like seven Fire Emblem characters. Alright, gargoyles time. Easy boss fight. Yep, easy. So our damage is... It's bad, okay? I know it might look like we're taking off a decent chunk of health, but that's because the gargoyles don't have very much health to begin with. Doing 30 to 50 damage a swing with a plus 5 weapon is... alarming, to say the least. Well, that was a good first... Wait, I'm alive? Oh, you two are gonna regret not finishing me off. I'm known for two things. Clutch comebacks, and accidentally self-destructing, so you have a 50-50 chance of regretting this. Sure enough, after a long-fought battle, the gargoyles fall to the knee of justice. It seems I've been challenged to a falcon ditto, and he even put on the gold alt. Don't worry, gross human skin alt is vastly superior, and we knee our way to victory. That being said, I think it's finally time we get some armor. I always try to find an armor set that at least sort of matches the theme, but good luck finding anything with this color scheme. I actually prefer this darker alt, and the black leather set is... sort of the same? It has the same shoulder piece? Eh, good enough. Alright, Capper Demon. Yeah. If you need more evidence why fist weapons suck, I present to you this bullshit. It was in this fight I realized the greatest strength of the Cestus, though. Applying fire resin lets you give a giant flaming middle finger to the boss, which is amazingly satisfying. After a few minutes, we melt the Capper Demon. Why are dogs the actual strongest enemies From has ever made? Pichu, you look a bit different. It's your fur. You dyed your fur, didn't you? Alright, gaping dragon time. Oh, that's not a lot of damage. What about your head? Surely that'll do more. Oh no. Okay, so it's about here that the Cestus kind of fell off in damage, and unlike the claws, I can't fall back on bleed damage, so yeah, that's about how I'm feeling with this game right now. Oh, don't you make that shrug. This fight took like 15 minutes. With our Cestus up to a plus 7, I'd say it's time to take on Captain Falcon's biggest enemy, Temptation.
Show me your moves!
You wouldn't hit a girl, would you?
The knee of justice is unisex. Okay, so the problem with Quaalag. That is the whole problem with Quaalag. She is an absolute tank. Fortunately, the smell of fire and brimstone filling the arena means we can just shove our face in her armpit and avoid pretty much all damage, and after a good fisting, she goes down. We hearth back to Firelink and buy some more pine resin, then head straight for the Moonlight Butterfly.
Will you please land?
Yeah, okay, thank you, Dark Souls. We had to 3-cycle this fight. 3! I feel so dirty and powerless. Whatever, let's just grab what we came for, the Divine Ember. Haha, only an idiot would get hit by that ball. See, I'm not an idiot because I got hit by it twice. That undoes the stupid. Man, no one would ever be insane enough to do a true knee-only run. Ha ha ha. Alright, Mr. Iron Golem, I am here to teach you some basic Pokemon knowledge. Steel types are weak to fire types. But I guess I'm weak to axe types. And apparently he's a psychic type. This isn't gonna be very fun, is it? Okay, so I know I literally just made a joke about his grab range, but like, seriously? Does this really look like an okay hitbox to you, FromSoft? Alright, enough beating around the steel bush. A couple knees later, Iron Golems becomes the Iron Gonlem. You get it? Because he's gone? Hanerlando. This sight almost makes all the pain I'm about to go through worth it. I heard if you just run up and then back away, they just fall off. Ha! Gonna quickly grab Havel's gear because I know I'm going to need it later, and then it's off to fight Better Godskin Duo. So let's talk... strategy. Ornstein likes to jump out of the way. Of, like, everything, and we lack the range to hit anything more than 12 nanometers in front of our face. Smo, on the other hand, is pretty slow, and weak to fire. So we flip the giant fiery middle finger, which, God, is still the best thing about this run, and... Yeah, you know what? That's actually serviceable damage. We aren't winning any prizes for the biggest numbers, but if we can manage to get 2 or 3 hits before needing to back off, this could go pretty well. The key word being could. Eventually, with enough patience, Smo falls before our mighty fist, leaving only Ornstein. Normally, that makes this fight easier as there's only one boss to focus on, but I'm at half health, out of essence, and we're doing that much damage. Let's just say I wasn't very optimistic about the outcome of this fight. But blow after blow, dodge after dodge, Ornstein's health would go lower while my anxiety would rise. I don't know how much damage his grab would do, and I didn't really want to find out. Eventually, I made a decision. I was going all in on this attempt, so we backed off and quickly menued to add humanities to our hotbar. It's a good thing we did too, because about 30 seconds after healing, we failed the no-hit run. I was getting careless, popping humanities and running in like I owned the place, but eventually, ONS fall before the might of Captain Falcon. Thank Guinevere, because I used basically all of my resources in that fight. Speaking of amazing chest ahead, I don't have a joke here, I just thought the view was earned this time. Things are getting kinda tough, I think I should lab out a few combos. Jab, jab, knee. A true zero to death on anything. I'm so glad Sakurai changed Ledge invincibility, it's the only counterplay to Ledge campers like Ceaseless Discharge. Further into the demon runes, it's time to take on the... I forgot to place the Lord Vessel! Okay, cup down, but I'm too embarrassed to go back there right away, so instead I slowly take care of the Hydra and set up for the DLC. To access it though, we need the broken pendant from the Duke's archives. While I'm here, might as well go pay Seath a little visit. They didn't nerf Captain Falcon's dash grab and ultimate, I could have closed that distance. This guard is sleeping on my Falcon. Literally. Alright, it's time for a rematch, best 2 out of 3, and I ain't scared. I'm only doing about 40 damage a punch, but that's okay as long as I don't get cursed.
I hate this game.
Okay, round 3, I even put on Havel's boots for extra cursed resistance.
I really hate this game.
I didn't even bother uncursing myself for this attempt just in case it ended poorly, but at about half health, I decided it was time, and just for extra insurance, I threw on all of Havel's gear. Eventually, Seath goes down. Well, I think enough time has passed, no one should remember I came here. Thick and Spicy is up next. Honestly, I don't have anything to say about this fight. It's not fun. Next is a boss that I was worried about from the beginning of the run, the Centipede Demon. I wasn't worried because he's hard, I mean, sure, he's immune to fire damage, so my wimpy punches are even wimpier, but I was actually kind of worried that having a modded in orange charred ring early might cause issues, but eventually he falls and I just end up with two orange charred rings. Does this mean I can do double fire damage? No? Okay. Next stop, Lost Content Land. Everyone always complains about the massive amount of copy-pasted dragon ass, but how come no one complains about how the lava has so much bloom it's basically irradiated? Like, to be fair, I've never seen lava close up, but I'm pretty sure it isn't red glow stick water. Bed of Chaos. We don't talk about Bed of Chaos. Excuse me? I am literally the fatality of Dark Souls, what are you talking about? Hearing Framp speak so poorly of me, I decided it was time to reunite with my teenage years and take a walk through a graveyard. Gotta tell ya, giving Patches the finger feels pretty good. Inversely, I almost feel bad for giving it to Pinwheel. I mean, we all meme on Pinwheel, but at the end of the day, he's just trying his best, right? Too bad his best wasn't good enough. Ha!
Got him.
Nito, the first of the dead is next. How do you think this will go? Yeah, me too. You may or may not have noticed that I've upgraded one of my cestuses to be divine. Normally, I just kinda ignore the skeletons or let Nito take them out himself, but when we do so little damage, I don't want them around the fight that long. Let's see how much damage we deal. 48. That's some good damage. It takes a good 10 or so minutes, but eventually we knee 9. Our knee does 9 damage. I'll be honest, I was trying to knee him for the victory, but this was a misinput. Whatever, 3 lords down, 1 to go. Before heading that way, I want to take care of an optional boss just for more levels. Whoa, that's a stage hazard. Banned. Stray Demon is the slightly easier, but still equally as thick version of the Demon Fire Sage. Actually, I don't know which one of them is the easier one, they're basically exactly the same. Like any other boss, we give him the finger then proceed to spend like 10 minutes in neutral until finally we knee him into the blast zone. I feel like I'm getting better at Falcon, I don't self-destruct anymore. Hey, I heard if you fall off this cliff, you get access to a secret item Sakurai doesn't want you to know about. Huh, so that's where it was. As a side note, wouldn't it be so cool if we got Dark Souls representation in the next Smash game? I'd make like a cool trailer here, but I'm pretty sure Premiere Pro would just fucking explode if I tried. Sif isn't as scary, we are a decently high level, which isn't reflected in our damage at all, but it is in our health. That massive anime sword isn't doing much to us. Unfortunately, that won't be true in the next fight. Eventually, Sif goes the way of my Smash career. Dead. My Smash career is dead. New Londo! Yeah, that's about right. Surprisingly, I didn't have much issue getting through this place. Even the ghost house wasn't that bad. But now I'm hit with a decision. I need to remove either the orange charred ring or the ring of favor and protection. Let's be honest, we aren't going to be able to knee this boss to death, but every Falcon knows its style above all else, so of course we take off the fap ring. Come here, you anime sword boy, I'ma show you what a real rushdown character can do. So there is absolutely no way I'm going to be able to out DPS the kings with this setup. It's not gonna happen. Our first attempt goes, well, about as well as you'd expect. Second attempt, I return wearing the Havel alt. That too goes about as well as I thought it would. It's fine, after watching my replays, I've analyzed why I'm losing. It's because I'm dying. With this newfound knowledge, I can turn the tables on them, and with that, all lords have been defeated. Before heading into the DLC, there are a few more bosses to take care of. First up, everyone's favorite Snake Boy. Snake.
Also, I didn't have anywhere else to put this in the video, but the reason I grabbed the Darkwood Grain Ring is because it sort of looks like Captain Falcon's backroll, so...
Man, they really nerfed Snake's zoning tools into the ground, didn't they? Whatever, we catch up to him and knee our way to victory, then it's off to the Painted World. You know the drill, jump the fence, open the gate, wave to the average Bayonetta main, re-dead the undead dragon, and finally jump attack the butt. Look, it's Peach except in her white dress alt. You know, I have a friend who is a Peach main. It's gonna be satisfying finally winning a 1v1 against her. Priscilla is... I don't know, she's not hard, like at all, but this whole invisibility thing isn't great. You're supposed to do poise damage to knock her out of it, but fist weapons don't really do poise damage. Fun fact, she can actually go invisible again after you knock her out of it. I never knew this. I guess I've never done so little damage that she's decided to recloak herself. Ah well, after playing in the snow a little while longer, she eventually goes down and it's time for the DLC squad. First up, the Sanctuary Guardian. He's easy. That's it. There's no joke. It was like fighting Incineroar.
Got him!
Stupid ledge invincibility. Next up on the DLC pain train, Byleth. I was super worried about this fight. I don't really care that I have such a low damage weapon. I mean, it sucks, but it's the range that gets me. I'd rather have a sword as long as Sephiroth that does like 3 damage instead of a fist weapon that does about 100. Fortunately for me, Artorias here likes to charge us with a very predictable and punishing move. We just got a spot dodge and jumping attack, and after the best microspacing you've ever seen, he goes down. Like always, we grab the pendant, mine the gap, give the mimic the finger, then make our way to the chasm of the abyss. Master Hand, you really need to get that glove cleaned once in a while. Manus is a slow process, but all we really have to do is bait out either his little temper tantrum or a jump attack and then punish. Not gonna lie, it goes against every nerve I have as a Falcon main not to be aggressive. Guess it doesn't really matter if he can literally flatten me from half health. Eventually, we get a read on Manus. He goes for an easily punishable ground slam and we take him down and move on to the semifinals. Oh god, FromSoft and their dogs. Well, at least gravity's on my side this time. You wanna see an idiot forget to equip Homeward Bone and then panic menu to not die? Okay, knockoff Rathalos, I might have thrown the first game, but this time, I'm gonna win. Best 3 out of 5? There isn't a lot to say about this fight that you wouldn't expect me to. Calamite has incredible resistances to everything we do to him. I will say that the Darkwood Grain Ring made this fight much easier than expected. I never would have thought that the extra distance and 2 extra iframes would make such a difference. Sometimes. After just 3 attempts, Calamite goes down and we move on to Winner's Finals. Man, Evo gets dirtier every year. So fortunately for us, Gwyn has a weakness to fire. Unfortunately, I have a weakness to swords. Funnily enough, that's 100% reflective of my actual Smash playstyle too. Put me against a Marth and I lose every time, so I think it's time we unleashed Falcon's true power, the perfect parry. I do my best to bait out his jump attacks, but even when I have him on the ropes, he turns it around and 3-0s me, knocking me into losers. But I'm determined, I know I can beat him if I get another chance. Fortunately, the guy I faced in losers finals also mains Gwyn, so I got a lot of extra practice. These references are starting to get a little weird. Oh well, doesn't matter, because after a couple more attempts, Captain Falcon wins Battle of the Kiln 2022 and links the first flame. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving a like and subscribing. It helps out way more than you know, and a special thanks to my patrons. Stay beautiful, y'all. Also, an extra special thanks to Xenofaux, the voice of Quaylag this time around. Please go check her out on Twitch. Link will be in the description below. This run was... not... bad? It definitely wasn't good, though. I really wanted the original run to be knee only, but the damage in the rain is just abysmal. It's
awful. There is a small part of me that would consider trying it again just for fun, but it's literally impossible to do as several bosses are completely immune to fire damage, but hey, who knows. The Cestuses themselves are not terrible? I mean, definitely one of the worst weapons in the game overall, but it's a fun meme weapon, I guess. I do gotta say though, being able to flip the bird to any boss makes this weapon an instant 10 out of 10. Anyway, until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.